I am so excited. What I'm going to show you has literally been in the making for the past decade. Let's go have a look.
But first, let's go back to the beginning. Years ago, I was talking to my friend about this fascinating rare snake. He looked for them in Egypt and said we might never see them again if we don't breed the ones we have in captivity. That's when I knew I had to do my part. And that's when the search began. After years of searching, scouting the web, not the dark side, I was content that I had to wait a few years for my friend to figure out how to breed his, and then I'll get some babies and raise them up. But then, out of nowhere, I see a post by someone else advertising this species. So I contacted my friend, the only guy I know with these snakes, and to my delight, out of nowhere, he was the one selling his beautiful pair of Pseudocerastes fieldi. So in May, I bought them, emptying out my account twice over. But I knew it would be worth it so I can do my part with this species. Firstly, I knew I wanted to try breed them this year. Well, 2021. So I chatted to my friend and he graciously looked after the snakes for a few extra months, as I bought them in winter and didn't want to move them across the country in uncertain weather. Subsequently, he cooled down the animals for me, which is a vital part of having any success breeding the species.
Guys, this is so exciting! They've arrived! I am so stoked, like you cannot believe. Gently unhook this, unclip it.
So I'm gonna lift up.
That is crazy. Oh my gosh, guys. This is a dream come true. This over here is the one, the only Pseudocerastes fieldi, also known as the Field's Horned Viper. It's a day later and I couldn't be more thrilled with these beautiful, stunning animals behind me. This girl is just, words cannot even describe what I'm feeling right now because they're just like more than beautiful. Okay, so today I'm wearing the best shoes possible for handling venomous snakes. You can't see them, but they're actually invisible bite-proof boots. So don't do what I'm about to do. Honestly, I'm really afraid at the moment because they are known to bite and eat each other and potentially kill each other when you add them to breeding. So I'm moving the female to the male's enclosure because the female's more food motivated and then the male won't be stressed about and just get straight to breeding. So we're gonna put them in now and watch them like for the whole day because we don't want anything to go wrong, but once we know they've settled for the first day, then we're all good. All good, and hopefully they're gonna breed. First of all, I want to kind of just tap the male a little bit to make sure he's not in a food response. Female's currently in a food response now, so I'm gonna take her out and just let her go on the floor a little bit. Okay, so I'm watching both of them getting the male out of the hide so he can move around a bit. And now for the exciting part we've all been waiting for. Okay, so it's generally the female that will go for the male. So in this circumstance here, it looks all good. They don't seem to be reacting to each other in any harsh way. I'm just watching the male there, making sure he's not wanting to bite the female. This is super, super scary. I'm actually very nervous at the moment. Please, guy, don't do anything stupid. But I do think the male's just interested in breeding, so that's a good sign. That's why they were both active, like looking for a partner, because they know it's breeding time and they got to make some babies.
After a couple of hours of patiently observing, I could see some promising behavior. And then I walked in on this. They were finally locked. That's basically the snake term for mating. Could it get any better? Well, to be honest, this part was actually horrific. The poor male was being dragged around by his hemipenes like a rag doll. To be fair, the male's hemipenes are covered in sharp spines, which is probably very uncomfortable for the female. Oh, and it's called hemi because it's plural, too. It kind of looks like something from a weird alien sci-fi.
Oh gosh, I'm quite nervous. My female fieldi is in her lay box at the moment. And I'm pretty sure she's busy laying eggs. Or has already. Let's lift up slowly. Oh
My freaking word. She's busy laying eggs. What the heck? Dude. Oh my gosh.
I'm freaking out.
Ha! Oh my word.
I just woke up. This is... you can see I just woke up. This is the best news ever!
Come on, stay still. I'm so, so excited. This is unreal. I don't know what to do now. I'm really... This is what I've been dreaming for years upon years. So I am really excited, and finally we got eggs from this incredible species now to incubate it. Oh wow, this is so cool.
So every now and then I come into the room, make sure she's doing okay, and take a bunch of notes because we gotta add to the scientific literature for the species, because the fact is we don't know much about them. So the more we learn, the less we actually know, because you realize there's so much more to learn.
And now one of the coolest things you're gonna witness, a snake laying eggs, but not any snake, one of my favorites. As you can see it coming out nice and slowly, the egg almost looks translucent. You can see the veins through the egg wall, and as it gets exposed to air, it starts to turn white. Pretty interesting, right?
I am literally over the moon and so excited right now. Come along with me and we gotta get a nice... No, we don't need a hook stick. There's a snake inside here and she's busy laying eggs. So finally, I've had success with the species, Pseudocerastes fieldi, the field's horned viper. She's currently in her nesting box right now. So I'm going to take the box. Don't worry, she cannot bite me from here. Oh, this is so exciting. We're gonna be collecting the eggs now. And we're gonna put the box on the table and see how many eggs we have. I am really ecstatic, over the moon. Okay, so I have a few things here ready at my disposal, because I have been taking meticulous note with everything with the species, because there's not much that we really know about it. So I can't really show you my notes because it's a secret. No, not really. But we're gonna weigh her. We're going to weigh the eggs. We're gonna make sure everything is all perfect. And I have a few egg boxes down here that we're gonna put the eggs inside. Wow. I cannot contain myself. Okay. Moment of truth. Are you ready? There we go. Ah, look at that. So you can see these eggs look very, very thin. That is because they hatch pretty soon after they get laid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20! 20 eggs! This is mad. This is insane, because, well, we don't actually know what the average clutch size is because there's not much known about them, but that's a freaking large clutch size. Here we go. She is empty. 7:44 p.m. There we go. We've got that down and dusted. And now what I'm going to do is I have a box over here. And this box just contains water, a nice warm amount of water that I'm going to put the snake in just to soak and rehydrate for a few minutes while I remove the eggs. Just because I don't know what to say right now. I'm just too excited. I'm kind of shaking a little bit just with excitement. This is how real it is. Like, look at that. These eggs, if you come have a nice close look at them, they are very, very porous. So you can see that I'm gently touching that egg there and it indents straight away. That is because these are very well-developed eggs. That one egg alone is 10 grams. It feels like a thin plastic bag with water inside. So now I'm gonna try two different methods of incubation with these eggs over here, because we don't know much about them and we don't really know how to incubate them properly. 223 grams was inside of her. That is mad. So I have two different incubation mediums that I'm going to try. I'm going to try and split the eggs, but the ones that are stuck together might tear and rupture. So I will carefully try and do that. If I'm not able to, I'll leave them together. It's hard for me to decide because I don't know which one's going to be more successful way of hatching them. So I'm leaving it up to you. Tell me. He's nodding or shaking his head. Come on, just help me. In we go. To now put it inside of the incubator. I'll just continue to meticulously monitor it, as my brother mentioned, because we got to do our daily checks. And remember, these are living, breathing organisms. Eggs do, in fact, need oxygen. So with this incubator, I've purposely built it myself and then also added a UPS system because of all our power outages we have here in South Africa. I don't want to lose the temperature control whatsoever. Yo, it's literally 11 p.m. and I'm sitting here right by my incubator and we've been struggling with our electricity for the last 3 hours maybe? Basically, it's not load shedding. It seems like a substation is down, so that means power's gonna be out for a long time. And it's the holidays right now, so yeah, I don't know when that's gonna get fixed. I did set up the incubator with a UPS system, so it has like 3 extra hours of battery, which is perfect if we have load shedding. And initially, because it's a grid system, our neighbors were still on, but a few other neighbors were off as well. So we ran an extension cable from the incubator to our neighbor's house, which was awesome. Thanks, neighbors, you're great. But guess what now? Their power went out too. So I'm sitting here and we've got to set the alarm clock for every 2 hours to wake up, switch on the generator, go back to bed for 2 hours, switch it on and off, back and forth. But if I'm being really honest, it's super, super stressful doing this. So right now I'm trying to organize where I can put you guys because, you know, I broke my tripod and haven't been able to buy one. So yeah, that's okay. Not really. I just created this table saw because if you don't have one, make one. Make a plan. You're only limited by your creativity in your brain. Ha! Got it pretty much accurate to the 0.0 of a millimeter. That's pretty cool. Well, not 0.0 of a millimeter, point, yeah, whatever. It started to rain now, so I gotta quickly see if this is going to work. I hope it does. Okay, it's raining too much. I gotta take this inside. Ah, yes, and I completed the enclosures that are specifically designed for optimal airflow as well as little to no stress on the animals. So it's specifically made for them and is placed in a position in the room that has airflow going right through the room because of my industrial extractor fan. Industrial. Come have a look with me. I am literally over the moon excited right now. In this box over here, we have an incubator. Guess what it's full of? Oh my goodness, we have one almost completely out of the egg. So I've actually recorded a full time lapse of over 10 hours on this. So let's hope we get something cool. We are going to just slit them open a little bit to make sure the babies are not going to drown inside because they can tend to do that. We have a few that have naturally split open the egg or slit the egg by themselves. So now we're just going to help it. So what I'm going to do now is gently, lightly pinch these eggs. I'm actually going to lift this one up. I'm going to pinch it to get rid of all the blood vessels that are attached to the wall because they're kind of loosely attached. Then I'm just going to make a slit in here so that baby doesn't drown if something goes wrong, like it gets tangled up in its umbilical. And then we have a slit and the baby is inside there. Okay, so we've cut all of these eggs, giving them the best chance of survival. We're gonna put them back in the incubator and I'm gonna show you the bunch that have already started coming out of the eggs because those need to be cut also. Look at that precious little baby. Oh my word. I gotta be very careful and remember that these are venomous snakes, so can't just like touch them and boop them on the snoot because oh my gosh, they are so adorable. And this egg, I don't know if it is alive still. Doesn't look too good, but look at that cute little baby. I just want to boop him on his snoot. Okay, so we're going to snip right over here, right next to that baby. Look there, did you get that? Oh my goodness, did you get that pop through? Did you? Oh my word, and it just got its first breath. That is so adorable. Oh my goodness. Now, with these being such rare and delicate snakes, I'm going to take the precautions like to the utmost level with everything involved. Okay, so what this means is I'm going to weigh everything with this gram scale that my brother got me for Christmas, because everything is like, these guys are super light, so I want to get them to the exact grams. Let's take the first little guy out. Oh my word, how cute is this? 6.78 grams. That is so adorable. Now, what's so fascinating with these guys is their tail is completely white. Come have a look at that. The ends of their tail is really, really white. What's weird is the adults do not have this whatsoever. The adults have pure black tails. So this is super, super cool. So what I'm gonna do now is open up this little enclosure and let the little guy go inside. Come have a look at this. There you go. And off the tiny snake goes into this massive, massive enclosure there. How cool is that? Then we close it up to give him the utmost security. Lots of airflow, he can't escape. Whoa, where are you going, little guy? One by one, we will get them all done in our tum tum tum. Well, we're not gonna eat them. Okay, so an easier way, what I'm gonna do now is coax him onto this little scoop. There we have him. Open him up and let him go inside his little enclosure. Go on, I specifically made this for you so you can thrive. Here we go. And now comes the really tricky part, to get these little guys to feed.